Hey everybody, this is your update for May 8th, 2020. Yesterday I exposed a lot of the PPP, and today I learned a new proposal bill that will impact the PPP loans and how they're managed by small businesses. So if you know anything about real estate and you know anything about business and actually getting loans, then, well, everybody would know this. But I'm going to break it down for you a little bit. The Small Business Expense Protection aims to allow small businesses to deduct expenses paid with the forgiveness PPP loans, right? So think about this. If you buy a piece of real estate, right, and let's say it goes up in value and you borrow against it, a lot of people will borrow against it. They're getting loans, right, and using that money to buy other property. It's how you basically expand your real estate empire, which is something that I think everybody should do. Real estate is absolutely an amazing place to generate wealth and also to grow financially and stably. So at any rate, when you borrow this money, this PPP is a loan, right? And that's why really it should not be taxed in the sense that you're getting a loan, right? But back in the day, if you remember 2008 and you had a bunch of loans, those loans, when they forgave it, they sent you a bill, right? Makes you wonder. If they forgive it, it becomes a bill. So they've got to address this. I think they're getting out in front of it, which is great. Now, we have a couple senators. I think Mark Rubio is one of them. There's another one that basically they're working to try and make this money not only be forgivable, but in addition to that, be able to write it off what you pay with this money, which is absolutely awesome if it happens. That would be like a miracle. Here you get money that starts out as a loan, so you're not taxed on it because it's a loan. They forgive it and they don't tax you on the forgiveness part, which essentially at that point it would be income, because if you're paying payroll, you're getting a benefit from it. So now that part's forgiven, but maybe they're not gonna tax you on the forgiven part. And then they turn around and they're gonna allow you to expense what you use that money for. It's like getting paid twice, right? And typically it's paid twice by about imagine you spent $100,000 that you didn't even earn. You basically got it. You got it in the form of a loan. They forgive it, and then on top of that, that $100,000 you get to write off on your taxes, right? That's amazing. Now, the IRS figured it right away. The Treasury Department's like, oh, wait a minute. Wait. Hold your horses. You don't get to double dip. This is really like getting the money and then getting the money again. I love it. I want us to have it, you know? So if you have senators that are out there, get on the bus of these guys passing the Small Business Expense Protection Act, because my goodness, if they let you deduct this, it's like getting twice the money. Think about it. You get to write off the money that you got, it's amazing, right? So the nuances in this really could benefit. I'm gonna keep coming at you with being able to help your small business navigate strategically through these times, because, you know, my favorite subjects are money, finance, real estate, business brokerage. So I'm obsessed with that and have been for 35 years. So you have some strategic advantages right now that are going to come your way. So it's going to be important that you pay attention and don't miss out. I know I'm getting calls like crazy of people that have already got their money. I know a lot of people are still in the process from other banks and other lenders and so forth, and it's a little slow. People need it now, especially when they're talking about, we're gonna give you more money. We haven't even gotten the money that we were supposed to get. Although today, this came in the mail. My stimulus check came in, which is great. Hopefully you got yours too. My name's the letter C. I don't know if they went alphabetical, but they were supposed to go in tiers of how much you made. So Mnuchin, obviously, the Treasury Department, they need to collect their money, doesn't agree with it, but I absolutely agree with it. I think you should get your PPP loan so it isn't taxable because it's a loan. I think you should get it forgiven because you pay some expenses because they've had you sit at home and watch your business go down and then turn around and let you write off everything you spent. I think it's wonderful. I think everyone should basically jump on the Marco Rubio bus. I think it's an extra stimulus. Think about it. It would be like doubling the PPP, especially when the Democrats are pushing so hard to push a bill that has it going down a corridor safety and health. And now Trump's saying that he just doesn't seem to be interested in doing another stimulus package, which could be posturing, right? He could be just sitting there going, you know what? I don't like what they're coming to me with, so I'll just pause for a second. The other thing is, when you think about it, all this stimulus, how much of it has really hit your pocket? How much of it, you know, the clumsy process of the PPP that I've been talking about and that I exposed, and the fact that a lot of people who need it and the lower amounts are not getting it, how many people still not received their stimulus check? And how many people have still not gotten the federal $600 a month for those independent contractors, those Uber drivers, the Lyft drivers, that it's stuck in their states? Now, I get comments about states opening up all the time, which I think is fabulous. Also, the EIDL is opening up for certain people. They're emailing them back about if they want more money so they can apply for more money. So you should see basically something about the EIDL program that comes in your email. The other thing is people in agriculture. We got an email from the SBA saying, hey, you know, tell people again, we've got this agricultural money. Make sure if you're in farming or agriculture, get out there, get to the EIDL and get your money. So again, more stimulus talk, but has subdued, but really this money hasn't even got out there yet. So we're gonna see. What I hear, what I've got a memo is about $185 billion has been accounted for in the PPP loans. That was a little bit ago. There's still $340 billion to get out there. So, you know, a lot of people gave their money back, those big companies, for PR purposes. But we still have time, and there's a lot of people that still have a chance. And I'm excited about that because everyone deserves to get this money and be able to keep their business going and alive and be able to strategically use this to make elegant, intelligent decisions that help you move forward in life. Especially after what we've done here, I hope that we roar out of it. Now, what's weird is the on Wall Street, they're basically, all the analysts are predicting like a real fast recovery, which honestly, we're not recovering really from anything. We just kind of stopped for 2 months. So it'll be interesting to see what happens there. Also, click down below, open up a Webull account. You get a free stock. And then if you fund it, you're not even buying stocks. You get another stock for free. So you can get two free stocks up to $1,200. If you haven't done it, get it. Watch the craziest game in town, the Wall Street madness that goes on. You don't have to buy stock, but at least you can watch it and keep up to date. And then we'll get to talk about lots of other things that come with watching that market and what happens to it. And just to wrap up the stimulus check conversation, the last date to go to the portal and to get my check is Wednesday, May 13th. So you have some time, but I wouldn't wait the last minute. Get it in there so that you can electronically get this, so you're not waiting around forever. Mine came, but at least you won't be waiting for yours. I'm Andrew Cartwright. Hang in there. And also, I know the lenders are processing like crazy, doing everything they can to make sure that people get it. We're getting a lot of feedback of how happy people are that they got all their money. They got all the EIDL. They got all their companies covered. And they're feeling very comfortable and very happy. So they're getting to them. It's getting out there, and the funds are hitting the streets. Not just the big boys anymore, but some people that to me really matter, you know. So they're getting their checks too. So anyway, take care. I'm Andrew Cartwright.